don't normally spring for a keyboard, but they're getting harder and harder to find for free. I ended up getting a real internet idea, colorful LED backlit multimedia gaming keyboard. This one will run you about $25, and then I think it was free shipping. So that's what it looks like on the front. I'm not much of a gamer on the computer anymore, but I grabbed this because I need another keyboard for my computer. I do my editing on my computer for the videos, and my DOS box needs my old keyboard, so I figured we'll just do a quick review on this. Something to cut it open with. Excuse my arm, it's not 100% yet, so it's got limited mobility here. It's getting better though. Okay, there we go. It's got some weight to it. It's not totally cheap. Let's get rid of the locks. Still got a nice new keyboard smell to it. Gives you a little booklet here. Shows you the rated current is 400 mA, rated voltage 4.5 or 5.5 volts. Speed current, I can't even read that. It says it's Windows 10 compatible. Doesn't say much more than that. Gives you the keys for turning up and you can adjust the sound or volume. Home key, play. Interesting. Oh, and this is for the backlight keys there. You can adjust the dimness. Not bad. It's got a metal-like look to the back, but it's plastic. It looks like it's made out of stainless steel, but it's not. It's bendable. Keys. Not bad. Not very loud. It's like the old compact keyboards. I like it. There's a gap in there. Now, let's plug it into the computer and see what it looks like. Well, hopefully you guys can see from there. I'm just going to quickly plug it in here. Let's close this. Plug my old one. I like the old one because in Windows 98 you can use the volume controls and everything on it, so it works great on my DOS box. Pretty much plug and play this old Microsoft keyboard. But I wouldn't put this new one on the DOS box. Wouldn't have the benefit of all the keys. So this one's fine for editing. Got little feet on there. Clean my mat up. See if it lights up the minute I plug it in. It may not. Didn't say anything in the instructions. And how bright it is. Ooh. Well, it's not. Let's see if it's plug and play in Windows 7. Is installing device drivers. Yep, it's plug and play. Nice. So it's got a really nice glow to it. I'll show you. Let me kill some lights here. It's not bad. I'll have to figure out how to cycle through them. Just let me take a look at the instructions. If I can get them all one color. I would like them all one color, like a blue. So when I'm working on the keyboard at night. Okay, well hopefully you can see this. It says FN plus page down or page up. So this is FN key here. And you get page up and page down for our brightness control. So that is as bright as it will go. I'm trying to find how to change the different patterns of lights. It doesn't really say anything there about the, yeah, I haven't found anything. Does not say anything about changing the patterns or anything else. Like, it just basically lights up, that's it. Huh. All you can do is adjust the brightness from what these instructions say. So what you see is what you get. Still a nice little keyboard for the price, though. That's basically what I wanted, was something that was low profile and lit up. But if you want something that does all kinds of weird-ass patterns, you're going to have to go with something different. I like it. $25, steal. Yeah, you guys really think I was gonna finish there? We're gonna just quickly pop it open and have a look on the inside. Because no one ever seems to do that on the reviews. And I like to do it because I like to see what I'm using. So like I said, the back is just cheap plastic. It's not... It's got this metal-like look texture to it, but that's about it. It's got some flex to it. Got your little cheap little feet. Those are standard. Must be a different model. Somewhere on down the road, there's a model that has a battery compartment there. Because it's in the mold. So we're just going to take all these out. This is, I like to check this out because sometimes I spill liquids in the keyboard. If I unplug it quick enough, I can clean it out. So for me to take this apart, it's what I normally do anyway, just to have a quick boo at it. If I have an accident, I can just pull it apart. Sneaky little buggers. The one key, the one screw that goes there is different, so I'm going to leave that one there. It's probably for insurance. You take it apart and, or it breaks, so you can't get a refund on it. Keep it. Oh, you little. Forget it. Forget what I said. I just blew their whole refunds just out the door now. Oh well. Just add that screw to there. No refund. If it blows up, I'll buy another one. Wow. Screws everywhere. That's weird. You have to know how one there. Okay, so underneath that we got some kind of shield. It's either a shield or that's the actual patterned LED strip on the other side of it. Yeah, it's just a shield. Metal. Funny, that's metal, but the outside isn't. And then we got a layer. These are, this is, I think, are you kidding me? This is the LED strip. Yep. Wow, they couldn't even use separate LEDs. They basically, I can show you that. Hopefully you can get that in the picture. They couldn't use just single LEDs underneath the buttons. What they did is they just put a strip of different colored LEDs along here. And it shines through the plastic. And when the light hits the areas of the plastic where it's there's a pattern on it, it reflects, instead of going that way, it reflects this way. So that's why it's not as bright as it could be. And there's only two wires going to that strip. So that means it's just it's a solid color. You can't adjust the brightness. Or you can adjust the brightness, but you can't change the colors of the keyboard. That's as cheap as it gets. But still good. I mean, you can spill the liquid on that, it's not going to fry it. And this here is cleanable. Ugh, this is going to be a pain to get back together, though. As you can see, all these little suckers are going to have to go right in the right spot or else it won't work properly. But, yeah, if you spill liquids in it, you could clean it out. So, I'll throw it back together. Maybe I'll plug it in so you can see the that panel light up. I don't even have to put it into the computer. I'll just plug it into my my power supply right here. Let's just kill the lights. Okay, hopefully you can see that. I'm gonna kill all the lights. And we'll just plug it into my Samsung charger here. Should light up. Yep. Looks like a Christmas tree. And there you go. So you could I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I hate the color. I would rather mount it all blue, or all red, or all green. But I don't like it like this. Down the road, I might take this strip apart, and I probably will mod it. I'll make them all blue. But you can pretty much do whatever you want. You could even modify some kind of backlight from an old laptop and put a cold cathode tube in here, or make them all white. That'd be kind of cool. Not big on colors. But easy keyboard to mod, and only $25. There's a new one. The old one gets a new home. Like last time I used this, it was plug and play in 98. Sweet. Let's make sure this works. Start button. Nothing yet. Maybe it's still plugging. It's still adding a driver. Yep, there we go. It's all good. I got my volume control. That works. Sweet. Later, guys.